The God of our everyday lives.
I am Sister Sylvia and belong to the family of the King William Sound branch of the Dominican Order. If God is the source of life, then who am I? A question frequently asked in life is, who am I? Why am I here? What is the purpose of life? These are very important questions, and by answering them, they give us direction in life. One of the first things my spiritual director told me was to spend time so that I can get to know myself. I smiled and thought, dear man, I know myself. But after a few sessions, I saw what he meant. I was thinking physical, psychological insight, but he was talking about my spiritual self. The vital question to ask is, what are my deepest roots? Roots that go beyond family, beyond race, beyond ethnicity, beyond being male or female, rich or poor. So, who are we? How about we are God's love song? The word person is formed from the Latin words per sonare, which means to sound through. Everyone is someone through whom something resonates. Each of us resonates something of God. Our lives reveal God. A person is sacred because humanity is first and foremost spiritual. Taher de Chardin says, we are spiritual beings having a human experience. It is from this point of view that we begin to understand our identity. A person is not someone who is subservient to a supreme being, but someone who is a dimension of God, the God who is the source of our being. When we fail to recognize or understand this mystery of who we are, we can suffer so much. Our lives are less rich and our relationships less satisfying. St. Augustine says, late have I loved thee. Why does he say this? Well, we know he was lost in the superficial, in that which gave instant gratification. And we also understand that the more elaborate our dress and lofty our titles, the easier it is to lose sight of the fact that our true identity and value have to do not with our social status, but with the mystery we embody. You know, we are not just a mother or a father, a teacher or the president, a priest or the pope. We are much, much more than that. We limit the glory of who we really are when we identify only with our functions and roles. Our identity is intimately linked to God, the source of our being. Tom Stella uses a lovely image to help us understand this mystery more clearly. Imagine the sea. What do we see before us? A vast ocean, a body of water that is both very deep and with waves on its surface. The waves are in constant motion, alive as it were, as though they are distinct from the depths, yet they are still one reality with it. It is all salt water, the high and the low of the sea. And persons are like those waves. We have a distinct shape and form, a life of our own, yet we are one with a much greater reality. Waves are as much salt water as are the depths of the sea. And we are essentially what our essence is. God takes great delight in us. Just listen to this.
Thank you. remember the songs that he sings, and I'll join him in harmony, rhythm and love. And the father is laughing for joy in his family, teaching that love is his greatest delight, clapping his hands with surprise as his children discover his story of peace, his truth and his light. That's the play of our lives, with a gentle hand waiting to see if we'll bend at his touch. Imagine the joy in his eyes as he watches his favorite masterpiece echoed in us. And the father is laughing for joy in his family, teaching that love is his greatest delight. Clapping his hands with surprise as his children discover his story of peace, his truth and his life. He fashions his word in the clay of our being. He waits for his word to be spoken on you. He is father and mother to all of our family. Joy is the fruit of his dreaming come true. And the father is laughing with joy in his family, teaching them love is his greatest delight. Clapping his hands with surprise as his children discover his story of peace, his truth and his love. Clapping his hands with surprise as his children